Anton Skoro with Pro MMA Now and Fisttacuff Radio, standing next to Gerald Harris. Gerald, how you doing tonight, dog?
I'm good. That sounded good. I like that. I felt like I was about to fight or something.
Well, I hope it's not me. So I gotta ask, man. Speaking of fight, like, what's on the calendar for you?
February 24th, I'm fighting in Houston, Texas, for Legacy Fighting Championships, and then in April, I'll be fighting hopefully in Dream One. I think it's called One FC or something like that. They're in Singapore, so I would love to go there. So I like vacations, minus the fight part. I like the vacation.
So I gotta ask, man, if the Singapore thing goes through, are you gonna spend a little bit of time over there after the fight?
Yeah, if I can, try to fix that flight, you know. I want to, you know, everybody cross title shot, but I think it'll be my next step towards getting that Dream middleweight title. So it'd be cool, man.
So, I mean, is that the big thing for you on the horizon? I mean, is that the number one goal right now, is to look at trying to get the Dream title?
Yeah, but my number one goal right now is the February fight. I never look past anybody. This guy's record isn't that great, but he's a good fighter. I've watched video. You know, I respect him. Nakamura, if you look at his record, he's like 14-12, but he's lost to 12 world champions. So I'm going one fight at a time. So cliche, but I had to say it. But I'm serious. If I look past February, I'll be in trouble. I won't get to March or April. So that's my number one thing right now.
All right, man. So with a fight like tonight, obviously King Mo putting some work in. I mean, that's your boy. How does that motivate you when you look at yourself getting ready to step into the cage?
You know what? When my friends do stuff like that, I want to copy that. Like when he knocked out Haja, I want to knock my guy the same way. It never happens. So it's motivating because we train together. He comes to Oklahoma and lives with me for like 2 weeks. And just to see the hard work he puts in and see how it pays off. You know, the nature of the sport, Larkin had some friends here too, and they saw him lose. So it's a double-edged sword. I love seeing my friends win, but on the other hand, I know that somebody has that bad feeling. I was actually sitting by his family, but, you know, the better man won tonight. So I wonder what's next for Mo.
I want to know what's next for Mo, too, and I've got to ask you, man. I was going to try to avoid this question, but, Gerald, I got to ask, man. It is. You're boys with Paige, and you're also boys with Mo. So I'm not asking you to pick, man. I just want to know, because everybody else going to ask you that question. Everybody else going to say who you pick and who you got. I want to know, man, how rough is it being in between the two? Because you're friends with Mo, like I said, and your boys with Paige. So you're like kind of stuck in between a rock and a rampage and a Mo.
Yeah, I am. It's a rock and a hard place. And they don't put me in the middle. Like, Rampage doesn't make me not like Mo, and Mo doesn't make me not like Rampage. I just can't say their name around each other. They just go off. Like, I mean, they don't like each other for nothing. So it was kind of like when Rashad fought Rampage. I didn't like it, but it was business. You know what I'm saying? Your boys don't like each other. They fight, and then hopefully they cool afterwards. If not, oh well.
All right, man. So I've been asking everybody this question. I got to ask you yourself this as well. 2012 prediction for Gerald Harris, man. What's on the map for you, man?
Man, I want to try to start knocking these dudes back out, you know. Suffered a broken hand last year, and that was really hard mentally going back into another fight because I thought every punch I threw, I was going to break my hand again. So I got that monkey off my back. I'm focused, and one fight at a time, but I want to start putting these dudes to sleep, man. Forget all these decisions, dude. So I'm predicting a bunch of people going to sleep after – this is lunch and this is dinner right here. So
he said 2012, you can check Gerald Harris out. He's going to have his own store. He's going to be selling mattresses and pillows, putting cats to sleep unconscious. So 2012, y'all get ready for the Gerald Harris mattress sale. I hope y'all got enough money.
Pillows, too. I like that.
All right, man. Anybody you want to give a shout out to? Thanks, Wise. Before I let you go, bro.
I want to give a shout out to my grandma's baby daddy. And that's all. No, I want to thank y'all for having me, man. So I just came here to watch my friends. And it was a great night of fight. So that's all. Thank y'all.
That's the business. And we out.